Retailers across England are hoping that pent-up demand will bring people flooding back to the shops tomorrow after a year of closures and restrictions. With a number of measures still in place, there's no guarantee that shops and restaurants will bounce back. Our home editor, Jason Farrell, has been to Covent Garden in the heart of London to see preparations for reopening.
Will Monday mark the beginning of the recovery? Covent Garden's gearing up for when restaurants can serve outside and non-essential shops reopen.
Do you worry that the world has gone online and it will never get back to what it was?
Not at all. Covent Garden's been around for 500 years. We're very confident it'll be around for a very long time. I think both of those things can coexist. And every time we've had a lockdown and we've had an easing of lockdown, what we've seen is restaurants full, shops full, queues to get in, people wanting to come out, connect with each other at a very, very human level, but also experience the best of London.
For many, the pandemic hit home with these images of London emptying out just before the first lockdown in March 2020. How could the bustle of 44 million visitors a year to Covent Garden just vanish? Back then, traders at Jubilee Market hoped it would be a brief shutdown.
You've been here since 78 as well?
Yeah.
But a year on, and the market's not ready to open, because last summer, they didn't have the trade.
When we did come back, the market was absolutely desolate. The West End was desolate.
Yeah.
But we were especially quiet because we depend on tourists, both domestic and foreign, and obviously there was no foreign tourists. There's no museums to go to, there's no theatres to go to.
There's no point you opening your business until...
No, until there's a reasonable footfall.
Over the course of 2020, the valuation of the Covent Garden estate has plunged by a quarter. The landlord has had to restructure leases and waive rent from struggling tenants. And only the hardiest kept going, like the florist who began trading shrubs to become a garden centre.
The Waldorf and the Savoy, they're not opening until the 17th of May.
Yeah.
So if there's nobody staying here, and there's certainly no theatres, I think it's going to take a lot longer than people realise to recover, especially in central London. Look at the streets here. It's empty. The only people walking around, unbelievably, are traffic wardens, where there's no cars and there's no people.
This is a place where time has stood still, where livelihoods have been put on hold, but now you can just start to feel it. The buzz is returning. London is getting ready to put on a show.
But the question is, who's coming?
This place can't thrive, can it, really? Until the airports are open and the hotels are open and the theatres are open.
I think it's a really good point. You do need a lot of things to work together. I think we have to remember that, you know, somewhere like Covent Garden, it's both for the international tourist, but it's also for the Londoner, it's for the domestic audience.
It's a slow, phased, uncertain coming back to life. On Monday, the Piazza will have 800 seats, heaters and umbrellas, food, alcohol, and hopefully lots of people. Jason Farrell, Sky News.